great idea. Taking the radio show and putting it on television. It's brilliant. Explosive television. Shocking television. This is genius.
All right, let me take a couple of phone calls, Robin. We'll just pop down the phones. We don't screen the phone calls. We don't screen them. We're very proud of that. Although I wish we did sometimes. Some days I get really freaked out. You're on the air.
Hey, how about a version of Electric Bee for Orlando? We haven't heard it yet.
Electric what?
Electric Bee.
Electric what?
Electric Bee.
Oh, psychedelic.
Psychedelic.
All right.
Psychedelic Bee.
All right, maybe we'll get
I've been
to
down here too long. I haven't heard it for a while.
All right, thank you for the call.
God bless you, Howard.
Bless you. Referring to my sixth grade band, I was a songwriter in the sixth grade.
You had two songs, yes.
Two hit songs. The other ones were not as big. One was Psychedelic B. The band was called Electric Comic Book, and
right.
I played keyboards.
And sang lead.
Sang lead and wrote the songs. And I also, my flip side of Psychedelic B was Silver Nickels and Golden Dimes.
Oh, yes.
Yes, the infamous.
Sometimes I forget about that.
Want to hear a little of that?
I love those songs.
A lot of people might want to hear that in Orlando.
This is a how old? 11?
I'd like to say 11. I would have to say, yeah, 11 or 12.
You were in sixth grade?
Yeah.
Yeah, so around 11, 12, yeah. Somewhere around.
Somewhere in there. Somewhere in that age group. And we even had go-go girls. In fact, I used to write to 16 Magazine all the time telling them there was a really cool band. They'd want to come down and take pictures of us. We were cute guys. They'd want to follow our band. We knew how to pose for pictures like the Beatles and stuff. But
you did a lot of posing.
Yeah.
You just ran around and posed.
And we would go down to Sam Ash to buy instruments and stuff and have no money. And we'd pretend like I knew six chords.
That's pretty funny.
But I was a hell of a songwriter. You got to admit, the songs are pretty good. When people hear my genius, they can't believe I gave up songwriting. All right, here we go. This is my sixth grade band. Personally, I'm not a fan of Psychedelic B. I don't think it stood the test of time. I think Silver Nickels...
You don't? Oh, come on. Psychedelic B is the one I remember. It's a standout tune.
Well, the drum solo in the beginning is awesome. Jerry Dickowitz on drums, Robert Carger on guitar, Howard Stern on lead vocals and keyboards. The keyboards, of course, drowning out everything else. We only rehearsed this 900 times.
Did they like your songwriting? Or did anybody care?
Everyone was lethargic. We just wanted to get girls.
Yes, yeah, so any song would do.
Yeah. How can this song get worse every time? Doesn't it?
It's such a drone.
I know.
I think I hear this when I go into those little Pakistani stores.
What are the words again? Let's see. It will be
a certain kind of thing that you'll always want from me.
Better than Fred's original music.
Oh.
Sorry. I'm just a little defensive. Hey, I was in...
You were only 11.
Right. Let's be honest. It's not that bad.
It's good for an 11-year-old.
Exactly.
It was early alternative.
Music. Right. It's very grunge. And I was dressed grunge.
Pre-Seattle.
I got to admit, the part coming up is pretty good. The what do they call that?
The
refrain?
The bridge.
The bridge?
And
and you want,
yeah,
want,
that part.
Want, you
yeah.
Like that part.
That's a really good part. Come in for the drum now. One, two, three.
Haven't you ever heard those little songs?
That's yodeling.
That's what it reminds
yeah.
me of.
By the way, the guitars were all tuned by the mailman. Came by once a day and helped us out. He was our roadie. Only dogs can hear certain notes. In the sky. don't know. I think I got a pretty good voice. See, first you'll see a certain kind of fruit in the sky, and you'll want it so bad.
It'll make you want to cry.
Or make you want to die, I thought.
No, it's crying. Okay. You were not as maudlin.
You cry? They found all the neighborhood dogs dead in front of a bus. You want to hear a little Silver Nickels and Golden Dimes?
Yeah.
All right. I don't want to interrupt this one because I happen to think it's brilliant. I wrote the lyrics. Robert Carger wrote the music.
Is that right? This was a collaboration between Carger and Stern.
Right. The Lennon.
Great team.
The Lennon and McCartney of Roosevelt. Yeah. Well, this is the B side, but I personally, this is my favorite. This is the one I thought was going to put us over the top.
Ah.
We used to send tapes of this. At least I did. I mailed them into 16 magazine.
Did you? The tapes. You didn't just stick to pictures.
No. I said, hey, come on, we're the next big... Because they always had pictures of Dino, Desi, and Billy, and I never heard Dino, Desi, and Billy on the radio or anything. They just had pictures of them. So we would go down to the high school, and we'd have to practice posing for an hour a day.
Yeah.
Like, we would just, like, pose on the bleachers. And, like, have different, like, big stances like the Beatles had on Help.
Sure. Do your album covers.
Yeah, album covers. We were like the Dave Clark Five, you know? And we had our, you know, and then we would, like, wear our pea coats. We'd all wear...
I do remember one picture. Weren't you all in, like, little suits?
We were playing a bar mitzvah.
Oh, that was that.
We never wore suits unless we were asked to play at religious services.
So you did actually get to play somewhere.
Oh, yeah. Well, Jerry Dickowitz had a bar mitzvah.
Oh, so it was him.
Yeah. So we got to play that first gig. We did two songs, I believe, Psychedelic Bee and Silver Nickels and Golden. No, actually, we did Wild Thing and something else. And Hang on Sloopy, because they were the same chords. Easy to do. Here it comes.
The nomination.
Miracle. I haven't felt like this since Mom and I won the mother-daughter bowling tournament.
The competition.
She's an incredibly talented actress. She gives a lot of class to our group.
The fashion.
Almost the most stressful part of the preparations is the clothes.
Join me, Steve Kometko, for a fast and funny hour with four of Oscar's favorite leading ladies.
The Academy Award nominee, Saturday at 6 Eastern, 3 Pacific, only on E!
I'm so happy!
If it happens in entertainment, it happens on E!
You're watching E! Enjoy!
You are definitely watching E!
It happens on E!
So you've chosen to be your own boss. Running your own business means doing what you love, doing what you do best, except one thing you don't love one bit, doing the books. Well, now you can say goodbye to your bookkeeping hassles forever, because the makers of Quicken have invented QuickBooks, the number one selling accounting software that makes it fast and easy to do the things you don't love doing, like paying bills, writing invoices, figuring out what your customers owe, even tracking inventory and doing payroll. QuickBooks makes it all hassle-free. How's this for fast information? A click, and QuickBooks shows you this quarter's income and expenses. And look, a few keystrokes, and QuickBooks does your invoicing for you, and then does the bookkeeping automatically. So you can get back to doing what you do best, growing your business. It's even easy to try QuickBooks. Call now to get a trial version for just $8 through this special limited-time TV offer.
That number is 1-800-826-2307.
How do you spell laughter? That's it, soap. TV's off-the-wall soap opera spoof that dared to be different is back with Soap, the collector's edition on video cassette, exclusively from Columbia House Video Library. Your introductory four-episode video is only $4.95. Soap is a simple story about two sisters, Jessica Tate and Mary Campbell, and their loving, dysfunctional families. Bert, Chester, Corinne, Eunice, Billy, Jody, Danny, the Major, Peter, Chuck, and Bob, and Benson. Yes, Soap, the award-winning comedy where every moment spelled out its own brand of humor. Soap, the collector's edition. Your introductory video features four hysterical episodes for just $4.95. So visit with the Campbells and the Tates.
Hi, Grant.
And you'll agree that there's nothing like family.
To get your introductory video of Soap, the collector's edition, for $4.95, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-321-8868.
Oh, now I feel good.
Do you want to talk to one of the members of the Electric Comic?
Who is on there?
Robert Carger.
Is that right? As a matter of fact,
your songwriting partner.
This is the he was the McCartney, I was the Lennon.
He wrote the tunes, and you wrote the smart stuff.
Well, sometimes we collaborated, or I would. So in the case of Psychedelic B, that was mine.
But your writing was a little bit more intelligent.
Did Carger add anything to Psychedelic B?
Yeah, Carger, the dee-nee-nee-nee-nee-nee, that was his. That was his. That was his guitar lick. That was the patented Carger guitar lick. Not only that, when we were at this Jerry Dickowitz bar mitzvah, the guy who was actually in the band, the bar mitzvah band, played drums for us.
Oh.
Or something. Oh, no, Jerry played drums. One of the guys played, like a guitarist, a real guitarist, and he jammed with us. We thought that was cool.
You're almost pro.
Is this Robert Carger?
Yeah.
Lead guitar player for rhythm and leads. How you doing?
Good. What? Listen, I figured I'd call in since I'm not getting any money for royalties. I figured I'd get on the air.
Yeah. What are you, in a car phone?
Yeah. Sorry.
I didn't know you had a car phone.
Oh, man.
Oh, you're doing good, huh?
Yeah.
Well, he's a real good-looking guy, Robert Carger. He was like the guy who attracted all the girls.
Oh, yeah? He got the girls?
He was Paul.
He was Paul.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I was more like Ringo. But this is a song that Carger and Stern Composition, Carger on music and me on lyrics for Silver Nickels and Golden Dimes.
Yeah, it was great.
Both of us.
Who was the mailman? Oh, were you joking?
I was only making a joke.
Oh, okay. My brother used to help us out.
Yeah, your brother used to. His brother was actually a good musician.
Was he?
Yeah, and we were smart, though. We got out of music at age 12, so we knew what we were doing. Here we go. This is what I consider to be our greatest accomplishment.
By the way, thank you for giving me credit for writing the music.
Absolutely. I remember it like it was yesterday.
It was yesterday.
All right, here we go. You might not want credit for this music. Wait, that's Psychedelic B again. Hold on, what is that?
I was going to say, Carger never played anything else.
Here we go.
Sammy, come play with me. We'll give you a silver nickel.
I sounded like a big homo. Or something. Mary, come play with me.
Yeah, but very talented homo.
Thank you.
Mary, come play with me.
I'll give you a silver nickel.
That was the mailman that said that.
Mary was actually a guy I knew. I was in love with him. That same drone.
A lot of trademarks in this band.
Remember we had to teach Dickowitz how to play that drum part?
It was impossible.
Yeah, he's the only guy we knew with a drum set.
Well, the last time we were on the air, we had the reunion. We still had to teach him.
I know. He was the only one. He had drum lessons and a drum set. And in order to get it just right, we busted this guy's balls for hours. I mean, just making sure.
You two were perfect.
Yeah, well, you hear, there's a big...
Yeah, we were perfect. Right?
We were. We were always right, and he was wrong. And we would pick on him and go, I don't know, we might have to throw Dickowitz out. And we go, I don't know, who else has a drum set? And then, well, you hear the big drum solo in this, and it took him, you know, we had to have it just right.
All right.
And you'll see why, I think.
Too perfect.
Yeah.
That poor boy crazy.
Hey, Howard, that bomb...
What?
That bar mitzvah we played at, was that Dickowitz?
Yeah.
That was his bar mitzvah.
Yeah.
That was our big show.
That was our big gig. That was our coming out party.
Was that your coming out and you're going in, too?
And then after we...
Coming out and going away.
Yeah, after we bombed at that bar mitzvah, and, like, nobody was dancing, we got two girls to be our go-go girls.
Right.
And we dressed them up in white go-go boots. We said, that's the problem. We don't have enough flash.
Wait a minute.
So I got two chairs. Yeah, we bombed. Of course we bombed. Nobody wanted to hear more songs. It was like losers.
Nobody cared.
We should have called our band the Losers. But we were convinced we were going to get girls off this band.
Oh, I think that's brilliant.
Yeah, right. I mean, suddenly they're like Paul Revere and the Raiders were like the London Symphony Orchestra. And we just wanted one hit song. I'm telling you,
that's all it would have taken.
But wait till you hear the drum solo. This is the best part coming up. And this, we busted his balls 100 times.
Yep.
Here it comes.
Yeah,
There it is.
Was that what yeah. he was supposed to do?
Sort of.
Yeah, well, it was close, but he never could get the rhythm down.
Carger and I had a dream, but we couldn't realize it.
Right, he wasn't smooth, Dickowitz.
No. He was very, very crass. Sounded
he
like
could
a,
keep a beat, but that was about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, sounded like a car crash with drums in the trunk.
Let's find out who the guy was who called in from Orlando. It's a fan.
Yeah, he was a fan. We ought to release this. Wait, here's the drum solo coming up. Wait. I think it happens twice. This was about prostitution, you know. No, it really was. I never revealed that.
I could tell that right away.
Did you know that?
Of course.
Oh, you did, Robin.
Yeah.
Past experience?
No, I just hear it in his voice. He's not telling her he wants to play for a nickel.
Right, and I'm also telling her she's going to go to hell for being a prostitute because it's wrong. See, Carger never understood my lyrics.
No, I had a tough time with the music. Very intense writing that
yeah.
stuff.
He
his music was about something else entirely.
He couldn't handle it. Nickel.
Hey, we should get together again and play.
Yeah, we should have another reunion. Isn't it our 25th
time
reunion?
Time to get that band reunion. Together again.
Hey, we should go play. You know what? The next time I do a live, like, funeral or something, maybe we'll bring back the band.
Absolutely.
And I'll perform.
Absolutely. I do it.
Is this drummer available?
Who, Dickowitz?
Dickowitz?
Oh, he's got a hard-on to be on the show.
Absolutely.
Are you kidding? He's absolutely available.
This time I'll make it, I promise.
All right, good. Yeah, because you weren't there for the last reunion.
I know.
But,
I know you know.
You got to be in the band.
Okay.
It's history.
I'm with the team.
All right, Robert.
All right, you guys take care.
Take care, man.
Bye. Bye, Rob.
They call it marijuana, and before this song is done, we'll explain to all you people how this outlaw causes fun.
You're waltzing up the red carpet, stars and paparazzi all around. Is it a fantasy? No, it's E! E takes you closer to the live action than you've ever dreamed. You'll have access to the stars and all of Hollywood's main events. See them arrive, who they're with, what they're wearing. Whether it's the Oscars, the Emmys, the Grammys, the Golden Globes, or live movie premieres. Ah! E's right there, live. Watch E's live Academy Awards pre-show, Monday, March 25th at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, only on E!
News from the front. Stalag 13, Colonel Wilhelm Klink rules his POW camp with an iron fist.
And you're the toughest commandant in Germany.
I am?
Oh.
Allied POWs, known as Hogan's Heroes, wage a secret war.
I see nothing. I know nothing.
In the USA, Hogan's Heroes, the collector's edition, is now available on video. Capture your first four episodes, including the original pilot, for $4.95 with subscription. The show is fast and funny, raves TV Guide. Join Colonel Hogan and his heroes, comedy heroes, for a barracks full of laughs, Stalag style. Hogan's Heroes, the collector's edition. Order this TV classic on video today and get four episodes for $4.95 with subscription. And World War II will never be the same.
To get your first four-episode video of Hogan's Heroes, the collector's edition, for only $4.95, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-537-7744. That's 1-800-537-7744.
A friend of mine told me, try America Online. I said, why? I've got a computer. He said, try it. You'll see. It's simple. Every time you sign on,
welcome.
It tells you if you've got mail.
You've got mail.
Want to send some email? Type the message, click here, and it's done. I like this. With one click, I can browse all kinds of great features on America Online. I've gotten help with my golf swing, I've planned my next vacation, even get stock price updates every 15 minutes. America Online has over 100 newspapers and magazines, everything from Business Week Online to Cycle World, and I can browse them all. With America Online, you can point and click your way across the Internet. And their web browser makes it easy to explore the World Wide Web. Call the toll-free number and you'll receive your free startup kit and 10 free hours to look around. It's worth a try. You'll see.
To try America Online free, call 1-800-410-9988. You'll receive your free America Online startup kit and 10 free hours your first month. Call now.
Oh, now I feel good.
A British newspaper reports that the Beatles, the remaining Beatles, have recorded together for the first time.
I have a tape of it.
Yeah?
Would you like to hear it?
Go ahead.
All right. Fred, give me the tape so we can play it. The Remaining Beatles is the first time it's been heard. Play it if you would.
They call it marijuana, and before this song is done, we'll explain to all you people how this outlaw causes fun. See, pot don't make you older, and pot don't make you fat. It just makes you feel real friendly, and you know that's where it's at.
That's George singing.
Is that right?
We once had a party with friends from everywhere. All the crazy old you name
these aren't the these are the retarded Beatles.
Flashing, drinking booze, running all about. Making small talk by the keg and checking each other out. The nozzle and his orchestra downstairs setting up.
Yeah. I think they've lost touch.
Do you really want to see the Remaining Beatles?
Yeah.
You know that the Remaining Beatles are completely out of it musically. You know, it's just...
What have they done separately? That would lead you to believe getting back together would make a big deal.
Nothing. It's just going to be the three of them combining for bad music. Do you have the actual... Come on, play the real tape. That's a remake.
Remake. Golden Omen.
I don't know. I have no desire to see the Remaining Beatles get together. I wouldn't go see them. And you know that even if John was alive, they'd still suck.
No.
It's, their time is over. They made great music. The Beatles were great, but...
It's over.
You see Paul now, he's like your dad. Sitting there with that vest.
He's got four chins.
Yeah. He's got Linda on stage. Any guy who had any self-respect wouldn't put Linda on stage. Get his woman under control. Show her tapes of OJ.
You always say it's Linda's fault. She says Paul wants her there.
Yeah.
I'll cut off your head.
George is in seclusion, gardening. Ringo. Well, come on. Need I say more?
All you have to do is say Ringo.
Watch this. This is good. That's cool.
You are so...
A billionaire Gramps.
I love you so.
A ruthless tramp.
He's not in yet.
A wife so sweet.
All I care about is my family.
A son who's neat.
Bart and I share a bedroom.
A power-hungry queen.
Shut up!
An amazing scene.
My cow!
It's the glamour, the thrills. Honey, sit back and chill. It's a Dynasty reunion you really must see. Saturday at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. Only on E!
Hi, I'm Matthew Perry. You are watching E! Entertainment television, you know.
It happens on E!
This weekend.
What the hell are you doing?
Go ballistic with the movie Rolling Stone says will blow you away. Travolta, Slater.
You're out of your mind. Ain't it cool?
Broken Arrow, rated R, now playing.
I cut my vitamin bill in half, thanks to Puritan's Pride.
I saved over 50% on my vitamin purchase.
Shopping with Puritan's Pride is like putting money back in your pocket.
Hundreds of thousands of people are buying their vitamins, minerals, food supplements, and more from the pages of Puritan's Pride. Why? Just look at our fantastic two-for-one prices. Imagine getting not one, but two bottles of C500 with rose hips, both for just $4.95. Two for the price of one. And look, buy one bottle of ginseng and get another free. Two for $6.25.
I bought one bottle of lecithin and got another one free. Just $4.65 for two bottles.
Buying from Puritan's Pride means you're buying direct from one of America's leading vitamin manufacturers and one of the largest. We offer a tremendous variety of products. Hundreds of the finest vitamins, minerals, food supplements, and herbs, including the newest products nutritional science has to offer. Puritan's Pride offers you a full money-back guarantee on every purchase. So call now for your free 96-page Puritan's Pride catalog.
Puritan's Pride, the smart way to buy vitamins.
The nomination.
Miracle.
I haven't felt like this since Mom and I won the mother-daughter bowling tournament.
The competition.
She's an incredibly talented actress.
She gives a lot of class to our group.
The fashion.
Almost the most stressful part of the preparations is the clothes.
Join me, Steve Kometko, for a fast and funny hour with four of Oscar's favorite leading ladies.
The Academy Award nominee, Saturday at 6 Eastern, 3 Pacific, only on E!
I'm so happy!
Oh, now I feel good. Hey, we need something good to show on E! Tonight. I was thinking, you know what's a pretty funny visual? When Scott the engineer pulls up his toupee and you see the glue? Hey, Scott, you mind coming in and doing that for us? Scott, I was thinking for the E! Show, you know how it's funny when you lift up your toupee?
Yeah.
Is that a toupee?
No.
You know what I mean, when you lift up your hair.
Yeah.
And you show everybody what's under it.
Mm-hmm.
Can you do that, or?
Not right now.
Why?
It's attached.
So.
I may be able to lift the front, but not the whole thing.
All right, yeah, that's what I mean. Just lift the front.
Hmm.
That's pretty good. Watch this. This is good.
That's
cool.
You are so bald.
Isn't that cool? You look so much better with hair, man.
Oh, man, he really...
Look at how bald he is.
Senor Wentos.
Scott went out and did a gig Friday night. You know, he has his 718 bag 5040.
Yeah.
Where he goes out and he disco DJs. You know what I'm talking about, right?
Oh, boy. Yeah.
Yeah. So Scott.
Oh, so something did happen.
Yeah. He knows what happened.
I'm dying to know.
So Scott.
How do you know?
I know everything. Scott, I'm like God.
That was Saturday night.
Well, you know, Howard, as you know, Scott's a different guy at the gigs.
Yeah, he comes to life.
He really does.
Yeah.
When he does, hands hot, up, hot, baby. Hot, and hands up, and all that stuff.
And he has that happening tuxedo.
That's right.
Tuxedo. There you go.
He becomes a different man.
He's like Tony Manero.
Yeah, Saturday Night Fever. Scott Salem story. Anyway, so Scott goes out Saturday night to do his show, and he's working his ass off, and he evidently did a real good job and everything. Mm-hmm. So he packs up all his stuff. He's going home. So I don't know what it was, but he's with his car, and he can't find his keys or something. He puts his keys on top of the car, and he got paid $400 cash.
Yeah.
He takes it, and he puts it on top of his car.
Stop it. You don't put money on top of your car.
You know, why he had to put his money on top of the car, I don't know.
I don't know. I don't remember doing that. That's the thing. I don't remember doing that.
Flew off like his hair.
Well, I'm sure if anybody sees Scott's $400, please return it.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Why don't you tuck your money underneath your hair? You got a nice little flap there.
I never thought about that.
It's a money flap.
I'm going to do that from now on.
Pick it up again. Take your money out and put it. I'm telling you. You got any money?
There's a pocket.
I think I get some
Scott,
money.
$20.
Oh, Fred's going to
give me
some
Give me a simulation here, Fred.
Change
now all the robbers are going to know.
Here you go.
Yeah.
Lift your hair.
Put your hands and your hair up.
Some people put it in their sock.
You take this, you fold it, and you stick it underneath your wig. Look, watch it. Look at it.
You're going to have to double fold it, Scott.
Yes, Scott. You double fold it. It's a little change purse.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look,
you never
completely
tell.
Hit it.
How does that look?
Great. That's terrific.
All right.
That is unbelievable.
Found the spot.
Now you should keep at least, $20 up there.
Now
so you can always get home.
Now you won't lose your money.
Just $40 more.
No change.
Put some change.
Yeah, change.
Here's $40 more.
Change isn't going to work. All right.
Yeah, beat it in there. See how much you can hold.
Couple of tokens.
All right, there you go. Right. Hey, there it is.
All right. Hey, good.
Oops, there it is.
I know that, but your hair looks better.
Yeah, you look like a young Elvis Presley.
It gives your hair height.
Yeah, it gave you some more height. You got a big pompadour in the front.
Good. I'm glad. Any more money?
That's a human ATM.
Scotty, how does it make you feel when you're in the hot seat there?
Well, I'm so used to it after 8 years, you just take it as it comes. That's all. Just sit there and ride with the flow. That's all.
Robin, I'll see you tomorrow. Eastern, 4 Pacific.